Okay, so we can continue. This is where we ended, and this is how our art is coming now. So you see, the lines there are too thin, right? So I think we can increase the line width property of our patch to have more bold lines. Okay, so let's just increase that line width. Line width. Hope that's the way you spell it. Okay, let's put something like three. Let's try and see with three what it gives us. Oh, that's too large. So let's go to two units, okay? Okay, that's better. Now, I would like the coordinate, or we are together, right? We would like the coordinate system to start somewhere down here, not necessarily right up here, okay? So we'll have to put it somewhere down. So how do we do that? Well, we'll have to play with the X limb and the Y limb property, okay? The X limb property, because here it is clear that this axis reference point will start, this is zero here, right? As you're seeing, right? So the zero here indicates that this is the zero zero of my axis here. I'll have to bring the zero zero of my axis somewhere down here. Okay, so for that, I'll play with the X limb and the Y limb property. The X limb and Y limb property simply tells me from which value to which value should the X axis go, and from which value to which value should the Y axis go, right? So that my drawing can be where I want it to be. So we are interested in arcs courses, right? Where is it? Arcs courses. So since we already know the values, okay, we can just put it here. I will have X limb, the X limb property, the limits of the X axis, the minimum. It has to be, sorry, it has to be the minimum. Let's just put a minus five. Error here, okay. No, rather, this is where we have to look, right? This is the last point here following the x, so it means let's say x will have to go from minus 15, minimum to a maximum of where does x end here? X ends here at 100, okay. So we'll put a plus 5 somewhere, so we'll say to 105. That will be the x limb. And then the y limit, we'll say the y axis has the same limits, right? From minus 15, it's a symmetrical or something, to 100 and to 105. Let's see what that gives us. Okay. So that's what it gives us. I think it's more beautiful like that, right? But there's something we are forgetting, if I'm not mistaken, right? We're forgetting to put the x and or rather the z and the x notation. So I think we'll rather put them inside, okay? We'll rather put them somewhere here. And this one too, we'll put it somewhere inside. Come on, don't stress me up. What's happening with this guy? Yeah, this place. We'll put it somewhere inside. Oh, sorry. I had to unselect the other one. Okay, so we'll put it inside like that. So how do we put the X and the Z? Well, we have a text function that allows us to write text into axis. Okay, so we will use our text function. The text function, we have to indicate what are the coordinates of X and Y. As you can see here, the prototype telling you that you have to indicate X, Y, then you have what? You have the string property that you want to be displayed. Okay, so following X, I think we'll do it with respect to this particular point here. So we'll say following X, we have 10. Let's say 10, but it cannot be 10, right? Because it is shifting again this way. So we'll put it, let's just put 20, right? and then we'll put 90. We'll see what it will give us, okay? According to what it gives us, we'll make adjustments. And we will put Z there. And for X, we will say it is instead 90 and 20. Okay, let's see. Let's see what that gives us. Okay, so I think that's acceptable, but I think we should go up again. Okay, so let's go to something like 95 and try. 95. So it's just a matter of representing the coordinates, okay, where you want your text to come out, and then you put what the text that have to be displayed is. That is all that is required here. Okay. Okay, now it's acceptable at least. We can try and increase, we can try and change the size, font size. Let's put the font size maybe to 10, if it's not already 10. And we will put the font weight. I like it when it's bold, okay? I don't know why I like it when it's bold. But if you don't like it to be bold, okay, you're free. I will not come and check your code. Okay. So. Okay. I'll increase it again a little bit. Let's go to 15 and see what it gives. Okay. That is quite beautiful, I think. And you'll bear with me, right? So it is not also very, very aesthetic to really see this white patch here, right? We would like to see just the lines on top of the axis. You bear with me, right? So what do we do for that? Well, all you need to do is to set the axis, not background color, okay? Not background color to be the same color as the one behind, but the axis itself, we can set it visible off, okay? When you set the axis visible off, it goes visible off, but leaves the graphics that are on top of it. And I discovered it, I was very, very excited because it's actually a very beautiful something to behold, as you can see. So now we just have our reference here, okay? That does not affect our main axis. I think we are okay with that, okay? So, this video might be shorter than expected because we truly needed just to finish that particular coordinate system, okay? So, we'll stop this video at this level and see you in the next video, okay? Oh, there is something that we can correct just in these videos now. Look at when we launch, we have diagrams, values. That's not what we're supposed to have. Elements. What's that? Element. What's that? Geometry and support, right? So that's a mistake. What do we have to do to correct that? We just need to go back, okay, to our code and set everything that is in the tab tool, okay, by default, when it's coming, it should come visible off. It should not be seen. Visible off. Okay. Okay. In here. Okay. In here. Okay. In here, okay, and here, okay. So let's try that. Perfect. We have our beam. When we come here, we have our diagram value. Then we come back to our beam and everything. So I think the main interface is okay now. Okay, so we can dive to some other thing in the next video. So thank you very much for watching, and see you in the next video.